Okie dokie. Let us revel. I'm going to start playing Wolfenstein, The New Order here in a couple of minutes. Everybody seemed to enjoy the last time I played Wolfenstein, especially enjoyed seeing me get really frustrated towards the end. Because, you know, I've got to fight the Nazis and fucking Godzilla. We will be drinking a particular beer tonight. Got my glass ready. This is kind of a little bit of the pre-show. For those of you that are unaware of how this program goes, we're going to be doing a little bit of a game and a little bit of a live stream. And then we're going to end whenever I damn well say we're going to end. It's an authoritarian show. It ends when I fucking damn well will it. Hopefully we'll have a lot of fun tonight, and hope all of you enjoy watching. We'll be debuting the beer tonight as soon as the fucking goddamn stream goes green. And let me pop out the chat here and have that as its own independent thing. So once this motherfucker goes green, we're going to start playing Wolfenstein, The New Order. Come on, go green, go green. Got to get my beer for this. But we'll start the game and then we'll go get the beer, okay? All right, we have gone green. Time to play Wolfenstein, The New Order. I swore I wasn't going to add another goddamn game to this fucking thing, but whatever. Everybody seemed to enjoy Wolfenstein, so. Especially watching me get frustrated. God, once more under the breach, dear friends. Once more. Fucking metal. Okay, enter. Loading profile settings. Let's see, options, enable, controls, I know the controls, video, whatever, don't fucking care. Let's see, can we go high? Let's just go with that. All right, looks like apparently aren't new. Bring them on, I am Death Incarnate, Uber. I'm gonna go with Can I Play Daddy because I'm not that good at fucking video games.
In my dream, I smell the barbecue. I hear children, a dog. I see someone. I think I see someone. These things. None of it for me.
She tended a barbecue or a pot of hell.
Among warriors. We come from the night.
Eyes open, Blazkowicz. You keep a lookout. I need to go to the pit. A shite! Blazkowicz, go back into the flight deck. Clamp the fuel line to engine 6, quickly! Find the tools in the tool cabinet. You'll need pliers and some bailing wire.
Okay,
You need tools? The tool cabinet is by the cockpit door.
Shit. Shut up! Oh, great. Ain't that wonderful? For those of you who don't know, Death's Head was the Nazi SS. What the fuck do I do? Fuck!
Death at the gates again. All in my name. Can't greet you today. I have a war to win.
Okay,
You're still breathing, you chummy bastard. You're tough as they come, you know. Jesus Christ.
Mayday! Vulture One, coming, Vulture One.
Medpack free, Blasco. Use it.
All right, I'm going to be right back, and I'm going to get the evening's refreshment, a surly beer. Okay, the beer for today is Surly. Surly Hell. Glass is designed to accommodate a 16-ounce beer. We'll see if that's true. I don't believe it will be. Nope. I have a little bit left. But good head on the beer. So.
Keep playing out your lads, Gadget. Hey, Condor 9, this is Vulture 1. You're crowding me. He's off.
Negative Vulture 1. Got a serious case of bad bush. You're needing to shuffle out of formation and you need to make room for Bergen.
Bosco, retract the radar. Pull the handle up there by those flashing lights.
Much obliged, Captain.
Appreciate your problem, Condor 9. I see smoke. I see solution coming off your rudders. Your freeze ailerons are done.
Yeah, this thing handles like a concrete bridge. Thanks for...
Condor 9! Come in, Condor 9!
Hey, that's a troop transport.
Condor 9, come in! Come in, Condor 9!
This is Condor 9!
Who's this?
Private Wyatt! Sergeant Knight Airborne!
All right, bear boy. Listen up, pay close attention. Now, you see the pilot's wheel?
Yes, sir!
Now, I want you to grab it as hard as you can with both hands and pull it towards you. Don't turn it, mind you. You keep it level, just pull it towards your chest.
Okay, sir! I think it's working! We're leveling out!
Okay, Private Wyatt, I need you to do one more thing for me.
Sir!
Have a man ready by the side door. You are getting visitors.
Roger that, sir!
Vaskowitz, get the cockpit open. You're gonna have to hold it open, then follow my lead.
Okay, I couldn't even go. Okay, I should have played this before the first game. We're drinking a Minnesota beer, and we're fighting Nazis.
Sir.
Go by it, Ken.
What's the score, Cat?
Do or die, son. Same as always.
Hoorah, sir. Thank God you're here!
Well,
oh, God!
Get up your ass!
Oh, Jesus!
Vultures 1, 3, 4, 8, 9 are down. Nice, slaves, then we'll have to abort. Blazkowicz, get this boy off the floor.
It's a negative, Condor 9. Maintain your course.
God damn it, Gordon. We're getting murdered out here.
Slap him!
Thank you, sir!
If this mission fails, we lose Europe. It's that simple.
We will fight, or we will make the Nazis pay for every goddamn inch they take.
If you don't stop
every
this
fucking inch.
We will lose this war.
I got an idea. Look, I've got to go. That's how compound's coming up. What's the command out? Condor 9 out.
Grab your ball back, Blasco. Breeze for impact. We're coming down hard. Fuck all.
I'm gonna kill me some Nazi motherfuckers.
It's the break of dawn. July 16, 1946. Everything has gone to shit. The Nazi war machine is advancing at an astonishing rate. And we can't catch up. Our tactics are failing. Outclassed and outgunned. No one knows why. People are getting desperate. Not me. I'm here to see an old friend and settle a score. Turn this thing around.
Mayday, mayday. Anyone over there?
Fergus, what's your status?
Blazkowicz. We've got a skitter that bad ways over here. Trapped inside an aircraft, well, some kind of armored hellbeast is trying to fucking eat it. No joke.
I've got the same problem here. Shacked up inside dead wreckage.
Is that you over there? Hey, Private Wyatt, flash your light. Blasco, can you see the light? Wyatt, turn off the light, turn it off.
Yes, sir.
What can I do? So that is actually the only way the Nazis actually win World War II. Is actually having technology beyond our capabilities right now.
Hey, perhaps you can swim here. Just keep your head down below the surface. You should be all right.
Good plan, Fergus. Coming to you.
Shit. Okay, apparently he can hold his breath indefinitely.
There's a high-powered machine gun nest in those trenches over there. We cannot advance a unit without being slaughtered. So
happy Monday, LA Kings fan.
Over into those trenches and take the nest out.
For those of you wondering, the beer tonight is surly hell.
We'll lay down cover fire from here.
Got it.
It's okay.
I'll radio updates from our position. Right, lads, you ready to lay down suppressor fire?
Okay, I'm dead. This is a lot harder than the old one. Jesus Christ! Yes, I am, LA Kings fan. Tomorrow and the next day, I should get through all of them. Where do I go? Thank you. don't even know where I'm going. How often do I drink? 2 to 3 times a week, as a matter of fact. The rest of the times I do games and beer, I really shouldn't label it games and beer. Because actually I'm drinking water. So, this is the one of the times that I'm actually drinking genuine bona fide beer. And probably doing a shittier job of it. Do I like Bud Light? You damn right I do. I'm Bud Guy. controls have actually changed slightly. Where the hell am I supposed to go? Okay. All right, let's take a look at the key binding commands. Troll. God damn it. Of course, nothing on how to switch from auto to... Because in my other game was Axe.
Are perched on the upper levels of the cliffside bunker. You have to put them out of commission. We have people in the air and those cannons are blasting us out of the sky.
No problem.
I
Damn it. Well, dear viewers, I have to pee, and I'm gonna pause the game wherever it lands me. Okay, good. I will be right back. How many shots can I take before I knock out? You're talking about me or the player character? Because me, not as many as you might think. Oh, actually, less than you might think. Especially with shots. Because shots, I don't know if you know this, my young friend. Shots hit you like a ton of goddamn bricks. You do 6 shots in, let's say, 10 minutes, you're done. You're finished. Like, I had 6 beers before I, did this lovely broadcast. And you wouldn't know it. Well, maybe you would. Whatever. I don't care. Not the point. If I did 6 shots of whiskey 10 minutes before I did this, right now I would be so drunk I wouldn't be able to do anything. I'd be asleep. That makes no goddamn sense. Oh, great. Challenging. What I don't want to hear. Damn it. Can you just walk and not throw your fucking gun, you worthless bastard? Whatever, I don't care. I hate Q. Oh, what are we doing? What are we doing?
Okay, Blasco. We made it past the stopper. Getting there to the cliff wall. Likely below Death's Head's compound. Gonna take a lot of fucking rope to climb up there.
Let's move along.
Hey,
Oh, it's a puzzle. Oh, whatever. I don't care. Oh. Good. Upgrades are good. Dust is good. Shit. Rambo, John Rambo, fucking Rambo, Rambo. Dear Heinrich, I hope this letter finds you well. I'm sitting outside the porch of a hospital recovering wounds. Blah, blah, blah. Good looking nurse. Okay, it's a fucking love letter. Damn it! Thank you. All right, all you mindless motherfuckers.
Damn fine work, Captain. We're halfway up the cliff wall, nearly at the compound. Meet you at the top, Lasco.
Hey, Private Wyatt! Much as I adore the view from up here, will you please... For the love of Holy Mother Jesus, climb the godforsaken rope!
All right. The hell am I shooting at? I don't know. What? Where am I shooting at? That? Whatever. Fine. Fuck it. Jesus Christ!
Good kid.
I'm sure you'll return the favor, sir, and then some. Here, I'll pull you up.
Pay attention, bear boys. This is all turned from a goose hunt to a stick-up job. And behind us now is a center pillar of the German army. What are you doing, you nothing bastard?
Private gate, sirs. Important for duty.
Well, crazy and dedicated. Welcome to the war. Take over, Private. Now, General Death's Head is nearer to us now than he's been in years. Some nasty wounds you've got there, Private. Be sure to mind that bleed. We eliminate the General, we cut the head off the crowd war machine. We don't, they're gonna have us for breakfast.
You all right there, kid?
Sir, my eyes are watering, and I think I'm gonna be sick. Is this normal?
It's just nerves. I'm gonna teach you a trick. Inhale. Count to four. Exhale. Count to four. All there is to it.
Well, having our ass tanned by some Nazi mutant fucking Frankenstein. So we ready then, lads?
This time, we get the job done.
Now let's go. Let's move it on. Go.
Lazy a wee roaster. This is a war, not a fucking Sunday church walk. Come on.
A good team. Like father and son.
Right. Captain Blazkowicz, Gates, Benson, your job is simple. Climb up this wall, get inside, locate the control room for this big fucking door and open it for us. You see any Nazi firearms, you take them. About to be better than ours.
The rest of us will cover you from down here. Now, once the door's open, we get inside, we work our way up through the building, we meet up again on the top floors, we find Death's Head, and we shoot him in the head.
All right, let's go.
No pressure, lads. But keep in mind, this may be our last chance. If we don't get Death's Head now, it is all over. Now climb.
I didn't see him coming.
That's up to you now, Blazkowicz.
Well, I'm happy to see you got back from New York City, Omar Sanchez. All right. Well, I also picked a crappy time to do this, middle of the afternoon on Monday night.
Get to the control room and open the gate.
Another kid you murdered, General. Captain. One of us is gonna die today.
Damn it.
Up towards the top floors. We'll meet you there.
Shit.
up towards the top floors. We'll meet you there.
Well, let's take him out by stealth. Damn it!
Moskowitz. We are closing in on what appears to be a courtyard.
Holy shit, I actually made it. Fuck. What do I think of people that say you must call them Caucasians, not whites? Nothing. Remember, Caucasians conquered the world.
Quiet, slow down, sweat, put that head. Frogbug, make some noise, Dad. What do you do, man?
What is the thing I hate most about Steven Reichlin? Arrogance.
This beam from our position. We're trapped up here, Blazkowicz. See if you can remove this beam from your possession.
Sir, maybe you can use this to pry it loose.
Come on, lad. Speed through.
Yes, sir.
You believe it can be done? Well, then, Beth.
I reckon you boys better jump. You first, Wyatt.
Go to church every Sunday?
Yeah, but you ain't got churches in England. You ain't got no priests there?
Yeah. Well, the Nazis sort of bombing them at the moment, so it's a bit of a problem.
Edward, Blondie, you're up!
Once again, can't order a fucking extra value meal number two without getting hurt.
What a fucking circus.
My feet are broken.
What is this place? There's ashes down here. There's a lot of ashes down here.
Hey, Wyatt. See if you can find a way to open that door. Move it.
See this pipework coming from that control box over there?
What is it?
Imagine it's some kind of
room-sized incinerator.
listen.
Yeah, I wouldn't vote for the Dems.
Sir, you have seen.
Okay.
Everybody still breathing?
Affirmative. The incinerators are off.
Any way to get that door open? I'd rather fancy leaving the monster up.
I won't open from this side. Hold on. I can hear someone out there. Someone's coming. Captain Blazkowicz, sir, come listen to this.
What are you people doing in there?
My people murdered so many times. I lost count.
So long since I practiced my English. Oh, it's a dying tongue.
Seen you before.
Oh, I like you. Such a resilient specimen. With you, I could do great things. Oh, I like the eyes. On this one.
Don't you forget Totem! Not this one. Somebody broke it already. It's a shit.
Captain Blazkowicz. Help me make a choice. In your opinion, which one of these two varieties would best support my research? Inadequate room
your sentence. Should you decline my appeal, I shall have to put a scalpel to both of them and we'd be here all day.
I'll make matters.
Shit.
All you need to do.
Right now, I have a Sophie's choice.
For the one, you would have me dissect. One captain make a choice for me. Yes. An astute selection. Young, unspoiled, fresh, tender samples. Fatty tissues intact.
You will save me, won't you, sir? I know you can do it. Sir!
No, I will avenge you.
General, that's it. Today he's teaching me a lesson. I've seen suffering and death. People maimed and tortured. Thought I'd seen it all. But I had never seen true cruelty. Until now. Count to four. Inhale. Count to four. Exhale.
Jesus Christ, what can Morgan this guy survive? Well, that's the beginning of the game? That's it? That's the beginning of the fucking game? Oh my God, really? That's the beginning of the fucking game. Oh good.
Wciąż nie znamy jego tożsamości?
Przez 9 tygodni nikt go nie szukał?
Nikt, panie doktorze, nie.
Nie mogę usunąć odłamki. Tylko pogorszyłbym jego stan.
Tak, panie doktorze.
W takim razie trafi do zakładu psychiatrycznego. Nic nie możemy zrobić. Mózg jest uszkodzony.
Tak.
Ma jajecznicę z mózgu.
Tak, panie doktorze.
Jajecznica.
Budził się.
Skąd wiesz?
Zaufaj mi, mamo. Po prostu twoja córka ma tajemniczą moc.
Ale twoja córka, ja tam się przy niej wiele nie napracowałem.
Tato! Przy oknie, w świetle.
Strange sensation. Trapped in my body.
Get up! Fight!
I'm losing time. Sometimes
be a fucking American! Fight till you got nothing left! Be a goddamn American! Fight till there's nothing left!
Asylum. She's the head nurse. That's her father, Shrink, and her mother, some type of pharmacist. They run the place, I reckon. Sometimes Christmas, sometimes birthdays, and sometimes Nazis come. They leave with patients in shackles, like it's Death's Head's personal candy store. And the Shrink raises.
God damn it! Fight! Signs. Be an American!
I suppose.
Stand up! Fight! God damn it! I can't believe America would ever get this dick kicked in the balls!
She takes good care of me. She takes care of everyone. She holds this place together. We're supposed to be married by now, but hasn't happened.
Seriously, I cannot believe that America would ever get this dick kicked.
Ihre Dienste werden nicht länger benötigt. Gruselig zu werden, Doktor. Sie haben zufriedenstellende Arbeit geleistet. Weitermachen.
Nicht die Betreuer zu töten.
Was war mit der hier?
Keine Ahnung. Bring's in den Keller. Von der
Entscheidung.
Come on, let me fight. Oh shit. Come on! You're an American! Get up! Get up and fight!
No one should be made to die like this.
hell did I do to enter that? Alright. Which, believe it or not, was actually part of Hitler's plan. Hitler planned not only to exterminate the Jews and the Slavs and the Russians, all the Eastern Europeans, anyone who had a mental deficiency, you know, alcoholism, drug addiction, whatever, Down syndrome, whatever, they were to be killed by the Third Reich. So now, I'm going to, go get another, actually, no, I'm not. I got another beer right here. And, let's kill some more fucking Nazis. I would just put this out. I'm the only motherfucker that actually gives you historical fact while playing the game. I can't in a T4. Like, what? No, that was actually Hitler's plan. You can bitch about it all you like, but it was. Shit. Yes. They were not on the scales to the Jews, though. Shit. All right, we've almost gone on 2 hours. That is more than enough. Hope this isn't fucked me up, but whatever. We're gonna ask. Yeah. Oh, that'll do a little riddle. Yes, I do want to quit. All right. What the hell did I just do? Look, Morshu, Omar, Arian is a concept. It is the thought of the perfect human. I guarantee you, the vision that Hitler had, and the vision that, let's say, Mahatma Gandhi had, are different, and they are the same fucking thing. All right, let's get to some videos. How about that? Okay. Hold up.
Let family fun reign with a McDonald's Happy Meal, featuring a toy from Disney's The Lion King. Now playing.
What is your hottest pop culture take?
So I read a lot of Marvel comic books.
All right. This is apparently a 2020 candidate who I didn't even know about. John Delaney. Before we get in there, what are my top five beers of all time? Budweiser, Bud Light, Coors, Coors Light, and then, I don't know, everything else. John Delaney? Isn't it in the mayor of New York? Wasn't he pissed off with AOC? Whatever. Let's hear what his 2020, whatever. This guy has no chance. Whatever. Fine.
What is your hottest pop culture take?
So I read a lot of Marvel comic books.
The biggest villain wasn't Thanos. It was Galactus.
You may be the wealthiest person in this race. What can you tell us about the claims President Trump has made about his own business record?
Well, I think he's a fraud. Let me tell you the difference between me and Trump. His dad gave him a ton of money to start. You know what my dad did for me? He helped me carry the furniture into my first company. I built businesses that were admired in their communities. I paid all my bills. We invested in our people. I created jobs. We innovated. What did he leave behind? Bankruptcies. Stiffing working people like my dad, because that was the kind of people he stiffed, like union electricians, right? He didn't build anything, he was a promoter. He just wanted to slap his name on buildings. He doesn't care about building, he cares about branding. I care.
Again, I have to bring up this tax return that Rachel Maddow published that proved Trump made $100 million within 1 year. Again, do I think Trump is the greatest businessman on the planet? Fuck goddamn no. But do I think he's in a complete failure? No. I've seen that on Shark Tank and Kitchen Nightmares.
We're about building something. Climate change has to be an issue that has to be tackled if we actually want to leave the world better than we found it. And I think that's our most fundamental responsibility. My first paying job was probably after eighth grade, and I mowed lawns all summer. And then I had a lot of paying jobs throughout my high school years working for my dad, who was an electrician. Most of my high school and college summers working on construction sites.
Good for you.
So I think on a number of important positions, that people are running on, I have come out against conventional wisdom. I'm for universal healthcare, but not Medicare for all. Let's not be the party that's telling 150 million Americans, of which over 100 million of them like their insurance, that we're gonna take that away from them. So the way my plan works is I leave Medicare alone, and then I create a whole new program that everyone gets as a right from when they're born to they're 65. And then over 65, they go on Medicare. So that gives every single American health care coverage from when they're born to the
you
end of their life.
You just lost to Trump.
And they don't have to pay for it. But I also say that if you actually don't want the government plan, you can opt out and go buy your own private insurance. Maybe you'll get a tax credit to do that.
Some critics have said that your opposition to Medicare for All may be related to your own financial connections to the healthcare industry. What would you say to them?
Well, nothing could be further from the truth. Right. My wife and I decided 10 years ago to dedicate the rest of our lives to public service. The opportunity.
Hey, now this. Just because you have someone doesn't mean you have to publish someone. Can be nap time. We'll finish this, though. I want to roast this asshole.
This amazing country has given me, a blue-collar kid, first in my family to go to college, successful entrepreneur. If I was worried about like my own financial interests, I wouldn't be doing public service with the rest of my life. People say Will Ferrell, so I'll go with Will Ferrell.
What is a tough question that you think every candidate in this race should have to answer?
Why are you doing it? At the end of the day, I think the candidates really need to look the American people in the eyes and say, this is why I want to be your president. You know, I know how I answer that question.
Donald Trump can, the only four that are going to make it through can't.
I believe I'm the person that this country needs at this moment in time. I believe our next president should be someone who's committed every minute of the day to try to take this terribly divided nation and bring it back together.
That was your question to all the candidates. Here is a question from one of the other candidates.
If you look back over time, innovation has always created more jobs than it's displaced. One of the industries I want to build is something called the direct air capture industry. They're like vacuums. They suck carbon out of the atmosphere. They work, but the problem is they're really expensive and they're subscale. I would have said the same thing about wind and solar 30 years ago. I'm going to be the president that is going to create a market for direct air capture technologies. We're going to locate it in the heartland of the United States of America. It's going to create hundreds of thousands of jobs, and we're going to save the planet in the process.
How do we pay for it?
Waze.
Whatever.
The funny thing about Waze, when I was in the Congress, so many Republicans would say, I don't want to be tracked. And they would say this while they're watching Waze and driving around. I'd be like, I think you lost that battle a long time ago. 9 hours, 22 minutes? That can't be possible. But how's that possible? I don't look at this thing 9 hours a day. Email, yeah.
Or if you're using Waze.
Right, if I'm using Waze. And I use Waze all the time. I think what people don't really fully appreciate about me is the things I'm trying to achieve are actually very progressive. Getting us to net zero by 2050. Ensuring every American child has access to pre-K. Reforming our immigration system. Creating a form of universal health care. These are the things I work towards, but the way I get there often involves bringing the government and the private sector and the nonprofit sector to work together because that's how I think we get the best outcomes. It often involves figuring out where you can actually find common ground. For example, on climate, I think I can get something done really big my first year as president with all the Democrats in the Congress and the Republicans.
Look, I hate to say this, but the photo of the baby really bothered me. I hate to bring this up, dude. Your party has swung so far to the radicalism that you want to take that little baby's head and rip it out of the mother's womb. That's where you are, buddy. And I have news for you. This is where the Democrat Party, I hate to bring this up, is gonna stay. Trump has fucked you up the ass. Anyway, that's the end of this thing. I may do another broadcast tonight, but as for this one, it is over. It's over.